Welcome everybody to Style Wednesday with the Queen of Style. We are back. We are back with our regular style show. And you guys know, due to the pandemic, we're not doing too much styling because a lot of people are not working at the present moment. But what we are doing is actually having different guest hosts with us who are in the fashion industry around the world, internationally. And we do have this evening, Mr. Richard Young, fashion icon from Trinidad and Tobago, who have done marvelous works within the Caribbean and international. As I say, it's Wednesday and it's 7 p.m. Remember to tune in to Style Wednesday with the Queen of Style, where you will get all your tips on what not to do and what to do and more. We now will welcome Richard Young to the platform. Richard, welcome to Style Wednesday.
Hello, I'm glad to be here. I haven't seen you in ages.
I know, and it's a great thing that you're here with me this evening because I'm like, okay, Richard has, I haven't seen him, we haven't spoken, and you have been doing so much great work within the Caribbean. So Richard, tell the people who you are as a fashion icon internationally, and let them know all the amazing things that you have been doing.
Well, I work in fashion, in many, many, many areas of fashion. It started with me being on the stage as a model 100 years ago. And I wanted to come off the stage to craft how we merchandise our creative wares in the region, because I felt it needed to be done differently from how we see it in North America necessarily and in Europe. And, you know, because I thought we needed to have our own Caribbean aesthetic. And so therefore I used my dance, because I was a dancer with the National Dance Association here, to use dance technique and the discipline of theater to inform how we present this fashion. And as a result of that, I work with photographers in styling, art direction, creative conceptualizing. I do writing for magazines. I do scripts for shows. I do proposals for private sector and public sector, all about how to incorporate fashion and creative industry into the new trend for the space. And it has become very, well, not popular, but I've worked most of the region. Most of the region. And like last time I saw you was in Montreal. That was at Montreal Caribbean Fashion Week.
Yes.
And so I've moved on to doing, Toronto. There is a show called Cutting Style. I worked in Florida. I did some things in New York. And I work most of the English-speaking islands, as well as the French and Dutch. So that's what I have been doing. They call me in to help mobilize the creatives so that they can become more empowered, and so that they can work their stories in a better way, because I'm about storytelling and how to sell your product in a unique way. And that uniqueness is what I bring to bear when I do stuff. So I just keep moving.
Amazing. So tell us, what were you working on the last project before we actually went into 2020, when we all got locked down and got stuck with wherever we were? And what is it you were working on or continue to work?
Well, what I was doing at that time, there were about 15 projects regionally, even internationally and locally, that all got canceled. I was going to resuscitate my model agency in March. It was already set for the end of March.
Yeah.
And I work with Nicole Dyer Griffith, who has a foundation called the Oxygen with Nicole Foundation. I'm the creative director of that. So one of the things we did in the COVID is, since we couldn't do fashion shows, we did videos, and we had something called Creative Conversation, where we got a lot of creative pioneers to come and sit and talk, and we fed it on Facebook Live, and it got a lot of traction. And so with the O2N Foundation, those are some of the things we have done. And I'm working on Miss Trinidad and Tobago World. Because of the pandemic, the girls, the young ladies have been kept together for a longer time, because the show is actually going to happen on Wednesday. So I had a whole day rehearsal today. I've been rehearsing every day. So the show is going to be done with social distancing and mask wearing and sanitizing. But we are going to do it in one of our performing arts theaters, and there are 14 representatives. So the training has been intense. I work with them on their communication skills. So, you know, I promote the whole storytelling approach and responding and talking about your journey and your story. So they have had several categories. They had the model, top model. They've had the talent section. All of that went on this month. We had the Beauty with a Purpose, which is a charity that they have to do a short film and be viewed and assessed. And we also had an interview session with a panel of judges to hear how they can handle the moment. So it has been very consuming in the last 2 months working on the pageant. So that's what I'm doing, and it's climaxing on Sunday.
Okay, excellent. So a question for you. Are you guys having carnival in Trinidad this year?
No, okay. Carnival. And there was discussion about doing a virtual thing, but I'm not too sure. There are some virtual pop-up ideas that private enterprise might do, and small promoters and some big promoters. But, you know, some people have been having concerts, but I don't think it's working as well as it could, because carnival is about the interactivity and reaching people, touching them, hugging them, laughing with them, whining with them. And so it is taking away that thing. So to the depression of a host of people, I haven't gotten my Tabanka yet. In fact, they have, what Tabanka is, that the term used here when you have, when you're missing something. It's almost like if you're, when your girlfriend leaves you and you're suffering a depression, they call it Tabanka. So they call it, all the people who are missing carnival Tabanka. And they have Tabanka special, is actually the fast food outlet.
Yes.
Because they're suffering from Tabanka. And they need to find some kind of way to align with what they're missing. But, so that's what I have been working on. And I have some other projects to do more videos, you know, because we do the videos going on fantastic locations.
Yes.
So I'm promoting internal tourism, you know, so I try aligning that with the Ministry of Tourism so that we go to special places so that locals could start to appreciate the beautiful spaces in Trinidad and Tobago, because they're always flying out. So you kind of turn the things around. Since you can't go nowhere, go to some of the beautiful places right here, you know, so.
And how have you felt about that? Because I think a lot of us are discovering the historic moments in our countries, in our islands, or even looking at how can I do more for my country or island at this time, because I can't go anywhere.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
I think everybody is forced to reflect on how they interface with one another, and it really is relying on creative practice. It's the creative way to do anything. Even in the scientific field, it is about doing things creatively now to sustain oneself in this different time. So all creative energy is what is coming to the fore. So anybody who can give an alternative way or non-traditional way of doing stuff, people are taking them a little more seriously. So creatives like myself, I think sometimes people come and say, help me craft a project, help me style a project, help me get my products across to people by using creative ways of doing it, whether it is videos, whether it's online, whether it is photographically, whether it's editorials, help me craft a way to merchandise my stuff. You know, so that has become very important, and it has to be done in a soft way. So it's not a hard sell, it's a soft sell. And right now you always have to impact people's senses. People need to experience things. You don't just want to force, buy this and get one free, or it's not about that. You must tell them about the experience, and they want to share the experience, and that's how they purchase. They purchase based on wanting to be part of the experience of what you are offering. So that's the new thing. And that is fortunate for creatives in a way. As much as it's hard for creatives, it's also a way for them to come up with stuff for people who don't necessarily have that inclination, and they still need to push their wares and their products and services, you see? So there are all kinds of interesting things that present itself for us to do, you know, and to collaborate with other creatives as well. You know, you work with people who have other strong points, you know, the people who work in graphics and video production, and the technological world has become accelerated. I was totally out of it. I can't even believe I'm doing this so normally now, because I did my training with a young lady from school on Zoom calls.
Wow.
You know?
Who would have thought, right?
Yeah. So I have been pushed into the technological world in a very accelerated pace. And I'm accepting it because I don't think it's going to go back. I don't think it's going to go back. It's going to be a new incarnation, a new way of moving forward, which will be a blend of human interaction as well as online interaction when the thing subsides. But I'm not seeing that for a while, the subsiding of the pandemic. So you have to find ways of making yourself sustainable now.
And that makes sense, because think about us who are in the fashion. We are so used to touching and feeling and being inclusive. Okay, let's meet on this island, or let's meet in this North America. Like, we are so used to be collectively together, and now it's a click of a button on Zoom, and we get the work done the same way. So I do think that is going to be the new norm for us to do more with technology. And I think that even for Miss World Trinidad and Tobago, I think when you go to the bigger platform, I think it might be something different as well.
Yeah, because I'm working with another young lady in a plus size show.
Yeah.
And her show is going to be virtual. So I went and she filmed her parade because she won an award. So she has to hand over to the new winner.
Okay.
And so we did it virtually, filmed it. So she's going to be presented next week, I think. And today she called out to me and said they're having her co-host because she won the humanitarian award for a show that was done in Houston with Fuller Figures, Miss Plus International or something. So yes, it has reached that point that the connection and the connectivity can and will remain to a great degree online as opposed to on-site.
Yes. And let's go into your awards. I know you have had several awards for fashion shows, fashion events. So tell us about that.
Well, I've gotten recognized a few places, you know, in Guyana, in Antigua, in Barbados. I got a Lifetime Achievement Award for fashion contribution in Barbados at the Music and Fashion Awards some years ago. A lot of recognition, plaques and trophies, just because I encourage young people to use creative process to earn income and to make livelihood and to make livelihood in a different way from what is expected of them, because that's what is happening now. So whatever you feel your creative energy is supposed to be channeled into your way of income generating. And so I help people with that. And the designers, I help them embolden their stance about who they are as a designer. It's not just about making clothing, and it's not about covering nudity. It's showing style, and style has to come from the Caribbean space with a Caribbean input. So it must feel like it came from this space, and therefore your life and your biography has to shape whatever you come up with. And so I make people move in that direction instead of just, you know, looking at magazines and kind of just making stuff that are in the magazines, you know? Because designing is about crafting new design thinking. So it's something that I encourage, because I didn't have a precedent for myself. I didn't have somebody to follow. There was nobody like what I do now that I could say I'm looking at that person and following that person. I ended up doing this. You know, I used to be a dancer, and then I was much slimmer, a lot more bones in my face. And there was this photographer who was traveling the world, and she shot pictures of me. And then there was an agency from California that came in here and did a scouting, and they picked me. And I went to carry models, but I got picked as the model to go abroad. Now, it never happened, but it made me realize there must be something that I have. But I decided to come off the stage and craft the way you walk, you move, you work for the lens, you move with the music, you handle the lighting, and my little drama and theater experience and my dance experience, I applied it to it, you know. And then I was very involved in literature. Literature is my favorite thing. So I would write, I read a lot, and I would write. So I'm able to craft how we're going to do it. So I come up with a concept, the music has to be designed to suit the concept, the movement has to be designed, the makeup has to be designed to fit the concept, the hair design has to be designed, and the lighting design. So I'm able to work with all those people. And sometimes, you know, and like after I finish this, I'm going to a sound engineer to build the music for the show on Sunday. Wow. So, you know, so you get involved in all of the things out of necessity. So necessity is the mother of invention is a true statement, the truest statement there is. You have to do it. Because I just started doing makeup and then I was known for doing makeup and it wasn't by training anyway. I read up on it after the fact. I just started to do it out of necessity, you know? And so, yeah, so that's how I got into the whole area of it. And then in the 80s, designers wanted to be launched. They had banned imported fabric garments here. So the young designers wanted to be launched. And that was the time I was active.
Okay.
So when I became active and I did this show one place and people saw it, they said, oh God, you have to get Richard. You have to come and do a show for you so that the audiences will be filled. The cameras would come, the newspapers would cover it. So that was it. So I became the go-to person to launch your brand. So everybody asked me, and it spilled over. And then I was going to Barbados and going to other islands and St. Lucia, St. Kitts, St. Vincent, right up the thing to the Bahamas. And then I went to Guyana and Suriname and French Guyana, Haiti, Guadeloupe, Martinique, you know. So that's what happened. It just happened organically. Somebody tells somebody. So it's not even because I have a website and I have, and my work is there. It was almost in the Royal Caribbean sense of elders passing on a story. You know, the old way of storytelling. Somebody tells somebody and that's how it is. Because that's when people ask me, how did they believe in you? How did they, who called you to come to Miami? Who called you to come to thing? Because when there was Pan American Games in 2015, my partner who I do shows with there, they approached her because they came to one of the shows I did for her. And Pan Am Games commissioned us to do a Caribbean fashion extravaganza in the middle of Pan Am Games in 2015. It was huge. Sold out, and people were shocked because we went with the best designers from the region. Was Calvin Shoutwell from Antigua, Noreen Phillips, who's a Vincentian living in Antigua. We had Claudia Pegas from Trinidad, the cloth. So we had people from around the region, Miranda Ashkey, who's a Dominican living in Antigua. All of those designers were brought to the show, and people were shocked at the caliber of the designers shown in Toronto. You know, and it was great, you know, and it allowed space for newer designers because I carried some newer designers like a Rian Romani, a Dominique LaRoche, Sean Griffith. Yes, I carried those designers because they have something to say that is not the regular statement of the first runners of the fashion design industry here. So I wanted people to see all the alternatives. So those are the things I have been doing, you know.
And I think that one thing that I love about your work is that it's not the norm. You go outside the norm. And yeah. I always say you color outside the lines.
Yeah.
And which is great because you have that vision and you're able to cascade that vision down in a show, which is really hard. A lot of people are not able to do that. A lot of people are not able to bring that vision that whoever asks you to bring to life. So it's really, really great to see that you're able to do that and they have trusted you to do that within, you know, a fashion event or a fashion show or a runway show or, you know, whether it's, as you said, depicting literature.
Yeah.
What is the greatest award that you have gotten that you are most proud of?
Well, beside the Lifetime Achievement Award, which is a Caribbean award that I got in Barbados, and what I got from the Harry Festa, which is our Festival of the Arts in the region, I got that in Guyana. Those are regional awards. But one of the awards here, there's a very prestigious, and I didn't win the award, but I was nominated, and I was nominated alongside some really large companies. They called me an export service provider, and I was nominated. I was in the top three for 2 years as a creative export provider. So it was really shocking, you know?
Yeah.
And then there was another event that also gave me an icon award in Trinidad for fashion. But I really liked the fact that I was identified as taking creative industry and exporting it. I am an exporter of creative industry. I go with creatives to places and I carry my expertise to brand and work with locals there. So when that was acknowledged, I thought that to be really, really like a high point of what I was doing, you know? And so, yeah, so those are the kinds of things that I would see make me feel proud of some of the stuff I've done.
And that's amazing, because sometimes I say to myself, which island are you in? And that's what I said tonight. Yeah. Are you in Trinidad or you got stuck in an island based on the lockdown? So, you know.
I had just come back from Guyana, actually. I came back from Guyana on Carnival Sunday.
Okay.
I played masks on the Monday and the Tuesday. And the 7 days after that, the country went into lockdown.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. So tell me a little bit about you have the pageant coming up on Sunday. What is the most the proudest pageant that you have put on or you have helped orchestrate that you feel that we always have that pageant or that show that we're like, oh my God, I put my foot in that pageant. Tell me like that one that you felt really, really amazing about.
Okay, so there are a few of them, but one that I am really proud of and it touched my soul is something I call Stronger Than Pride. It actually was a male pageant in Antigua. And working in a situation where you have to change mindset and people's psyche because they were wondering why pageant and males were being used in the same line, because people think pageants are feminine or female.
Exactly.
And all the guys were very manly guys and they were very nervous to take part in it. And because of the approach I made and the people I utilized working with me was the lead creatives of Antigua were involved in the show, you know? And I used my experience and expertise to craft it. And there were like 1,500 people at the hall in a country that had 60 something thousand people. And it was grand. And everybody came to the show and the guys changed. Some of them cried. I met all of their girlfriends, the potential fiancés. It was a huge changing of people's expectations about men in a shoe parade. You know, and they went on television on programs that they normally would never have been able to go on to. So it was very proud. And to hear them talking about me, like there was a time, it's very touching. I was sitting in a car park and I got them on this show called Feedback, I think, which is a political program. But they went on to that show and I was in a car park outside of a gym where one of the guys was training. So they told, somebody told the gym owner, I was sitting in a car waiting on my friend. She went into the grocery. And they called me into the gym to sit and look at the interview and say, you need to be proud of these guys. And I was overwhelmed that all the jump guys were standing there. They put me in a chair and we were watching this on a big screen.
Yeah.
And one of the guys said, Richard Young taught us how to love. And I was just broken in my stomach, you know, because, you know, it's a whole mindset because we went and we worked with underprivileged young men who were homeless and they built an annex for the home and they carried their clothing and shared it to them. And one of the guys in the show actually found his best friend living there that he had lost and didn't know where it was. It was very emotional. So it was a very, very, very impressive show. And when the promotion for it, I got them to be bareback on the beach playing tug of war with members of the army. So I said, it's stronger than pride. It's more than personal pride. It's more than national pride. And so they were like winning the tug of war with men dressed in their army fatigue. And that promotion went crazy. And I think that was really special. But I've done a number of other things. I've done Caribbean pageants. I worked with JCs. I worked with Caraval. I worked with, there was a Creole, Miss Creole in Dominica. Mm-hmm. I did model competition because I used to work in model competitions. There was Synergy Supermodel here. I was on Caribbean's Next Top Model with Wendy Fitzwilliam. And I did another one, a Caribbean Supermodel competition with about 30 Caribbean islands participating. And I've done several, many pageants, too numerous to mention. In all of the countries I've gone to, I've done Amerindian pageants with all of the Amerindians from the interior of Guyana. They came forward and I trained the girls for 3 months and put on a great show, getting to learn their cultures. And so it has been. I've done other male pageants. I did Manhunt in Trinidad. I did Mr. World in Trinidad. So a pageant to me is just a parade of the best of us.
Yes.
You know, and that's what I call beauty. Beauty is the best of us. So you parade it and show the culture, the best culture, the best way of doing it, the best story, the most entertaining crafting of a story. And that's all it is. So, you know, I put a lot of concept and obligation when I do a project. You cannot be doing a project and it's just to join the bandwagon of projects.
Exactly.
You have to add something to the menu of projects around the world so people will identify that that is special, you know? So when I do that, some of my friends say I beat myself up too much. I pressure myself too much. And sometimes when people see me nervous, they say, but it's going to be okay, as it always is. I'm never okay. I'm always on the edge, you know, going forward and doing it. So that keeps me sharp, I suppose.
Absolutely. You know? So which one do you prefer? Pageants over modeling, fashion?
I like fashion. I like the showcasing of fashion. And there are many concepts and ways of doing it that I want to go into. I have some friends who work in creative fields as well. And we want to do some creative ways of showing fashion. It's not just about a runway show. It's about finding interesting imagery so that it can be remembered. And that is why we prompt the sales, because sometimes people used to say that I was taking fashion shows and turning them into entertainment showcases. So I had that, people would see that, and I said, yes, it is that I'm doing. In the Caribbean, people who go to shows want to be entertained. So since they want to be entertained, I have to entertain them to prompt them to purchase the garments. I can't do the first world way of doing the fashion show, because that's not going to prompt the audience to come and sell out the house.
Yes.
So I have to find a way to bring the audience in the house and you get your stuff sold. As long as I'm able to merchandise and get your stuff sold, it means I've done my duty with the show. You know, so the end justifies the means. So it can't stay just in the form of, okay, this is white shirts with collars and lapels coming down the runway and it's branded X2YZ1 and the price tag is there for you to purchase. Mm-hmm. That's not the nature of the Caribbean people in a show space.
Exactly.
They want to be, you know, mesmerized. So you tell the story in an interesting way. You have script, you have fabulous lighting, you have fabulous makeup, you have fabulous music. Mm-hmm. Make them experience something wonderful and they will remember what is going on and they will remember the designers.
Absolutely. Yeah. So, What else do you have working on for 2021? I know you talk about revamping your model management, your model agency. Is that something on the horizon that I should be looking out for? Yeah.
Yes, as long as I get, because we were crafting it, Richard Young is looking for the new find. So we had already done it and it was going to be not just runway models. We were going to be looking for commercial editorial models. We would have been looking for spokes models. Mm-hmm. We'll be looking for models who used for illustrations. So we were going to use one of the hotels here, and each area was going to be designated to specialty areas of modeling with a panel sitting in each room picking people. And then we're going to pool them into an agency per se and then work that through the advertising agencies and position them throughout the region. And I have some other partners who are friends of mine who believe in this approach because it needs to be organized and professionalized. So we were going to do that. I still want to do that, and I still want to do the video work.
Yes.
In promoting designers in new ways. Fabulous location, fabulous imagery. Taking the opportunity to tell another story. You know, since I have your attention, let me tell you another story. A story about our country, a story about our history, a story about our geography. So I implicitly get into your mind and tell another story while I'm selling the garment. So whether it is a tourism product story, whether it's a historical story, whether it is destination marketing, whether it's just cultural enactment with dancers or whatever, another story happens while the garments are being sold. And so that's what I think is the responsibility when you get a stage or you have a lens. Mm-hmm. As long as you have a lens focusing on something, you have to try to tell people more than just one thing. And so that's what I try to do.
Okay. So Richard, tell the people where they can find you. Do you have a website, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok?
Oh, good. Well, I am on Facebook. I have Richard Young PR, which is my public page, and I just have Richard Young, which is up like a private page, but you can reach me there. I have an email, which is richardyoung5181@gmail.com. And I am on Instagram at richard_a_g_young. So it's richard_a_g_young. Because those are my initials. And those are the ways, and you would not believe it has worked for me. So like that Montreal Caribbean Fashion Week that you came to, I had done two others before.
Yes.
And I had met a woman when I did a show in Montreal in 2004. Mm-hmm. And we just met. So when she was ready to do the show, she went on Facebook and that's how we met. And she flew me to Montreal. I'd just done a show in St. Lucia and I went straight to the airport and head out there. And what was nice about that year is that I sent a girl to an international model competition in Shanghai, top model 2004, and she won. Mm-hmm. So while I was doing the show, she called and told me she won, the first black girl to win top model in Shanghai. So that was great, you know?
Yes, definitely, definitely. So it's been amazing. I know you have a lot on your plate, but I know it's thank you for taking time out today to discuss with us. I hope when Trinidad opens up, we could do some work together in the future for 2021 and look on the horizon for 2022, you know, and connect some time because it's overdue, Richard Young. It's overdue.
I was so surprised when you reached out. I said, oh my God, Wendy and I hit it off in Montreal. And I was in New York and I wanted to try and track you down because I'd been in New York for the last 2 years, every year, twice for the year.
Yeah.
And I was always just consumed because I went to do a show in Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. And when I come back into New York, I'm just swamped with the amount of people that I have to connect with. I also was invited by Fashion Institute of Technology to come and do a talk at the museum on Caribbean fashion, which was a hallmark event and it was packed. And so that was good. And I always think I have to check Wendy because she's somewhere here, you know, but I've been so busy when I get
there. You know, well, let's try to connect once we open up and you're coming to New York. Let's just get our schedules together and get it right. Yeah. And we could actually do something and actually put something on the horizon for 2021, 2022. Because it's long overdue. So thank you again for joining with us on Style Wednesday, Richard Young. And thank the audience too. It's always a pleasure to see you and talk to you. Guys, remember, it's Style Wednesday and it's the Queen of Style. And I have the fashion icon in the Caribbean, of the Caribbean, the amazing Richard Young here with us. Thank you so much, Richard. And have an amazing week. And good luck on your show. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye. There you have it, guys. Style Wednesday with the Queen of Style. As I usually say, don't let the fashion wear you. You wear the fashion. And until next week, Wednesday, we'll say, have a fashionable week. Thank you.